My name is Gabriel and I'm the CEO at FarmAnywhere. We build container farms and today we're answering all of the most common questions that we get about container farms. So let's get right into it. What is container farming? And what is container farming can change quite a bit. There is the hydroponic versions as well too, but then you could also grow in soil and you could also grow a little bit like in a greenhouse or inside of a building. There's no real set rules. Your actual parameters of what can be grown inside a container is just limited by the size of the farm. All right, so the second question we get often is how much does it cost to start a container farm? And again, that varies between different companies out there. For us, our lowest price is $69,000 for a 20-foot container. And then it could go all the way up to $250,000 for like a research container with a ton of sensors and a ton of different parameters that could be put in, a ton of different equipment. So it really depends, but that's a good range. Next question is, what are the advantages of container farming over traditional farming? Well, for sure, if we're talking about traditional farming as in agricultural farming, well, you know, their traditional agriculture is always more prone to pests, almost more prone to the weather outside. Like today it's windy and sunny, but yesterday it was rainy, so you always have to constantly adjust to that. If we're talking in terms of traditional farming indoors, then obviously the capital is different, right? Like if you're setting up a farm indoors in a warehouse, you're talking about millions of dollars at a time, most likely to set up a huge operation, as opposed to container farming, you could kind of scale up. If we go back towards traditional agriculture, obviously in container farms, you don't have to deal with the weather as much, you don't have to deal with pests as much, you have a whole lot more control about your environment. And really we have to look more, the real question should be, what are the parameters for controlled indoor agriculture? Because at the end of the day, that's what's inside a shipping container. Next question we have is, what crops can be grown in a container farm? And you can refer back to our website, and every single manufacturer out there has their own page for that. But you know, popular stuff is all kinds of leafy greens. So lettuce, herb, chards, bok choy, things like that are super duper popular. Mushrooms are really starting to come online in 2023. And then you also have microgreens and hemp. Those are all things that could be grown as well inside the container. And then the possibilities are endless. If you're in the research side of things for a university, then really could be set up for all kinds of stuff. We're working on a project right now to do research on hops for beer, for example. So, you know, obviously in terms of return on investment, that would not make sense, but for research purposes, the containers are perfect for that kind of stuff. Next question is, how much can you yield from a container farm? And again, depends on what you're growing. It's better that you do your own math. And the way you do the math on that is calculate the exact square footage of the grow space. And then you could go online and figure out what kind of plant spacing you need. And then from there, you could do the math. Manufacturers tend to do Excel calculations, like we call it, and inflate the number of plants or the number and the amount of yield that could come out of a container farm. And so that's why we kind of thread lightly us at FarmAnywhere about that part. We'd rather show you how to do the math and be able to use sliders, for example, on our website to be able to calculate what kind of yield you should be receiving. So total square footage of grow area is the number one question you want to ask, or total plant sites. And then from there, you can decide what you're going to be growing. So let's say, for example, is Grand Rapid lettuce, then you could find all kinds of different information on that. Let's just say it's 250 grams per plant. And then you could do your math from there as to what the yield should be. So fairly simple on that part. Next question is, what is the energy consumption for a container farm? And again, that depends on the setup. You're looking anywhere between $30 a day, all the way up to $150 a day, depending on the power cost that you have in your local. So right here in Canada, we have 9 cents a kilowatt hour at the moment of filming this video. But in Europe, sometimes they're close to 40 cents a kilowatt hour. And there's a big difference there, right, in the operational costs. So the real question you should ask is, how much kilowatt hour does a container take to operate at its maximum capacity? And then you could do the math from there. So for example, our mushroom farms takes 30 kilowatt hours to operate. And therefore you could do your math from there with your own local environment. Next question is, how do you manage pests and disease in a closed environment like a container farm? Well, that's the beauty of it, right? It's biosecure. So obviously there's some container farms out there that don't have a lobby like we do. And therefore, when you walk into the farm, you walk into the actual grow room, and it gets a whole lot harder to be able to manage your pest. On our side here, we have a lobby that you can do all your gowning up and you can go, so you maintain a way better biosecure environment there. So that's one thing. And then obviously the same type of stuff that you will use in a greenhouse. So integrated pest management, so a full standard operating procedure in terms of being able to read if there is a pest issue, how to mitigate the pest issue, and then acting upon that pest issue based on what it is, which is, it could be fumigation at the end of a cycle, it could just be beneficial insects. It all depends on the situation. So the same process that applies to greenhouse methodologies or indoor agriculture can be applied to container farms. The advantage though is that if you're running multiple container farms, you can afford to do a full shutdown of that farm, do a full sanitation process, and then reboot that farm as if it was brand new again. And in our R&D farm that you see behind me here, we do that very often, actually do a full reset. Next question is a container farm sustainable? So if we're looking at sustainable in terms of environmental here with that question, well, it all depends on the manufacturing process, right? Upcycle containers, for sure, it helps. It's the container that's not going to waste, for example. And then what material goes inside the actual container makes a big difference as well, too. And then in terms of actual CO2 output in the environment, if we're looking at leafy greens, it's very little. And if you're looking at the power, well, it all depends on where you're located. So if your power is with green energy, like us in Canada, most of it is from green energy, like hydropower, for example, then it's very sustainable on the environmental side. But if you're in a state or in a Caribbean island where they're using coal, obviously the footprint will be a bit bigger. Next question is, how does the technology in a container farm work? Well, there's two ways of doing it. So there's system integrators like us at FarmAnywhere. We don't spend any time doing any R&D on technology. We take the best technology out there, integrate it into one package, and then make sure that that works well together and ship that to you. And the advantage of that is that all that different technology package is maintained by different companies. They're really, really good at what they do. They specialize in that. We also try to get container farms that technology that doesn't have subscriptions, so you don't have a recurring fee on that part as well too. So that's an advantage. And we also try to use technology that can be plug and play, that you don't have to have necessarily like a tech come in and replace it, off the shelf part. And that kind of gives you security that if ever, for example, a company were to go bankrupt tomorrow morning, well, you're not stuck, right? It's supported by all these other different technology providers. Then on the flip side, there's the technology makers, the ones that actually do everything in-house on the technology side. They R&D everything, they support everything, especially on the software side, and then they charge subscription most likely as well for it too. And that has its advantage because it's a tightly integrated package, and most likely it runs really, really smooth together. Sometimes not, but most of the time it does. But at the same time, you're vulnerable for the points that I just mentioned on the integrator. So you kind of got to decide what you want to do. Do you want to have a Apple style ecosystem where it's kind of closed down and you can only work that infrastructure that's been given to you? Or if you wanted something that's more open source where you kind of build on top and you could kind of change with the times and you could kind of fix yourself and have support from multiple different companies, that's really up to you. The next question is, how can I scale my container farming operation? And so if you have an existing container farm, obviously it's to know your numbers down to a science, right? You got to know every single input and output down to the penny. And that allows you to really be able to figure out where you're spending money on and where you can save, where you're spending your labor on and where you can save. And then from there, you start making your generative profit that's stable. And then from there, you could use that to leverage a second and a third farm and a fourth farm, depending on what your situation may be. So I'd say it's a bit of a packed question to answer quickly like this, but I'd say that that's a good start, is just know your numbers on the accounting side. And so that's what it is for part one of most asked questions that we get. If you want more of that, definitely like and comment below. If you have any questions, obviously contact us on our website, farmanywhere.ag, and we'll definitely be there to help you out.